The saying goes that there are no new ideas out there. Every new invention is just a mashup of other things. But when it comes to e-bikes, who's complaining? Extra juice to go with your pedal power? We'll take it. And some serious breakthrough designs are coming in the industry too. Let's take a look at the contenders for the title of most innovative e-bike of 2021.
To get notified when a new video is posted, hit the bell icon below, right next to the subscribe button. Thank you for watching Mind's Eye Design.
If you're going to crash on a bicycle, a helmet is the best way to protect your brain box. But what about staying upright in the first place? The Swiss company Strahmer has an upgrade to its flagship model that promises to help. The ST5 now comes with an anti-lock braking system that offers maximum control on slippery surfaces, as well as rollover protection when braking in full. This executive model comes with high-end components, including integrated head and taillights and a 48-volt battery, giving a range of 112 miles per 5.5-hour charge. The top motor-assisted speed clocks in at 28 miles per hour, so you'll get to class or your job with enough time for breakfast. This bike hits dealers in June, so look out, puddles, grease, and mud. The Strahmer ST5 is coming for you. The Canadian company Bitrix popped onto the scene last decade with an offering dubbed the ultimate fat e-bike. It's now pushing the next edition, the Juggernaut Duo, which can be spec'd any way you like, from a capable city commuter to a monster deep mountain machine. Bitrix admits it aimed for a maximum range of 200 miles, but even its real use range of 150 miles is nothing to sneeze at. It accomplishes this by combining a 1,500-watt mid-drive motor with its largest capacity 21-amp-hour extender battery. This also means the bike can hit 35 miles per hour, although you can put a limiter on the top speed to meet local regulations. Wouldn't want to go too fast, would you? Or would you? Next up, the Shuttle EMTB. That's E Mountain Bike, for those of you who hate acronyms. This bike is also an upgrade to a previous series with some notable new features. The model arrives with a hefty 726 watt-hour battery, nearly 50% more capacity than the last version. The charging port has been moved up near the head tube for convenience, and the carbon fiber frame has seen some modifications for optimum performance. There are three riding modes: Eco for maximum range, Boost for speed, of course, and our favorite, Trail mode, which uses algorithms that vary the amount of battery assistance depending on the type of terrain. This bike doesn't come cheap, but you do get what you pay for and more. And with its remarkable craftsmanship, it may just be the last bike you ever buy. If the Revo hubless e-bike doesn't have you at hello with its astonishing spokeless design, there's even more than that to grab you. Over 2 million bikes are stolen every year in North America, but you can kiss that worry goodbye with this stunning vehicle. Those missing spokes belie its stealthy anti-theft feature. The one-touch fingerprint sensor works with an automatic lock housed within the frame, out of reach from bolt cutters. And the GPS tracking system with motion detection creates a geofence that lets you park and leave your bike just about anywhere. Plus, with integrated lights and motor, you'll have everything you need with one quick 3-hour charge. The CNC eFanes Enduro Mountain e-bike is different. Aluminum bike frames are typically made of lengths of tubing joined together by welds. This frame is milled from solid aluminum, using a computer process that builds the two halves by selectively removing material from an entire block. It then welds the frame right down the middle. This leads to less distortion of the frame over time. And a bonus, you can now sport a mullet without getting made fun of. This mullet bike has a 29-inch front wheel, but a 27.5-inch wheel in the rear. This e-bike is all business and all party in the front and back. The 52-volt dual-motor Grizzly from Aerial Rider boasts more power, more speed, more efficiency, and more extended range. And they don't seem to be kidding. The bike uses a patented metal gear tech for torque, and the high-power battery only adds to the brawn of this machine. In fact, there are two batteries, so you won't experience range anxiety like with other bikes. Speaking of which, there are two motors, too. And coupled with the dual suspension, the Grizzly is a bear of a machine. With two of everything, you may end up buying two entire bikes yourself. If you're tired of shifting gears in response to the terrain, but could also use a little help pushing the pedals, the Valeo Smart e-bike system may have the bike for you. This motor produces 96 foot-pounds of torque, which, according to Valeo, magnifies your pedal power by a factor of 8. It also claims to be more efficient, despite running at a beefy 48 volts instead of the more standard 24 or 36. Not only that, this is a bike that responds to you rather than the reverse. The 7-speed adaptive gearbox means no more fussing to find the right gear. Now, you can enjoy the scenery whether uphill or down. Time Warp, the world's biggest indoor techno festival, has collaborated with Superstrata to celebrate the convergence of technology and music with an e-bike that shines, of course. The Superstrata E has an electroluminescent coating that's nearly invisible. But once you turn it on, it makes it look like the bike is painted with light itself. And with the battery inside the tube, you get a sleek, aerodynamic, power-assisted ride. The carbon fiber frame is also printed in one piece, custom fit to your dimensions. Electroluminescent unibody. That sounds like the name of an EDM track, doesn't it? We've been looking at e-bikes from a bicycle's perspective, but maybe we should start comparing them to motorcycles. High-power cycles Typhoon Pro now comes with a jaw-dropping 8,000-watt power system that rivals any zippy dirt bike. Finally, all your off-road ambitions can be realized. Actually, staying on the road looks pretty exciting too, with speeds up to 50 miles per hour. The upgraded model includes a souped-up drivetrain and hydraulic disc brakes, as well as a suspension overhaul that could be fine-tuned to the rider's size and weight. However, we have discovered the one thing missing from a cycle with this much punch: a seatbelt. You might not know that the first Harley-Davidson bike had pedals. That's right, the 1903 bike, nicknamed the Serial One, was born the same year as the company. And now, it's come full circle. Or should we say, cycle. Harley is making an e-bike, and it's only fitting that they named the series after the first bike they created. The Serial One collection is an impressive lineup of bicycles, including the urban playbike Mosh City and three Rush City models that offer a few design and speed variations. All are equipped with a 250-watt motor that will give you the edge in any city drag race. The Serial One retains Harley-Davidson's signature attention to design and performance, but moves in a decidedly different direction, more trendy and minimalist. And of course, slightly fewer decibels.